Hello everybody, it's Jess here with Blush Jess. Thank you so much for watching. I have a super fun video for today. I haven't done one of these like this. I've been really wanting to film my kids' birth stories, tell you about how they came to be into this world. And I wanted to do Lucy's around her birthday, which is in like a week. So I realized, well, if I'm gonna do Lucy's, I really need to do Nate's before that. So that is why today I'm gonna be telling you all about Nate, how he came to be. And I'm really, really excited. I'll try to throw some pictures in here too. So you guys grab a cup of coffee, you know, let's just hang out. I'm gonna be sharing Nate's birth story. So the first thing I want to say, well, let's talk about pregnancy first. So if you haven't watched the video where David and I talk about our miscarriage, I will try my best to remember to link it above and below. But we did have a miscarriage before Nate. And it was an extremely hard time in our life, but we immediately started praying that God would give us a baby after that. You never realize how empty your arms are until after a miscarriage. And we weren't really trying before that to get pregnant, but now we started trying because I was like, I just need a baby. And I know that God put this desire into my heart to be a mom, and I'm ready to be a mom. And we miscarried and met in May, and within like 2 months we got pregnant with Nate. And I remember, you know, trying for a few months, and the periods I had in between those times, it was so upsetting. And, you know, just really pray. I know that doesn't seem like a long time, but, you know, after going through the miscarriage and stuff, it was just really hard to get the periods and deal with all that. I hope this isn't too TMI. I'm going to try not to be too TMI. And I remember it was Labor Day weekend, and I really hadn't having any symptoms or anything. It was super early to even test, but it was like, oh, my period should be coming, you know, soon, and I wonder if I could be pregnant. And so I just was like, I'm gonna go ahead and take a test. And so I went to the grocery store to get some groceries, and I came back and I took the test in the bathroom, and I remember looking at the pregnancy test, and it showed that I was pregnant. Like, the line was like faint as anything, because like I said, it was so early. And I always thought, like, for the first time when we miscarried that pregnancy, you know, I, you know, went to David and I told him in like a really sweet way. And this time he was in the living room, and I just ran in there with the test. I was like, oh my God, it's positive. And I just was like in such shock, and so excited and yet terrified that I would miscarry again. And so the doctor had told us, as soon as you get a positive test, call us, like, you know, really soon, and we'll try to get you in even earlier. So we immediately told, like, we decided not to tell like anyone at church or any, like, you know, people that weren't like close friends or family. Mostly I think we just told family at first. So we called our parents, and I remember calling and being like crying, like, I'm really scared. Y'all please pray that this pregnancy is, you know, a baby at the end of it, that he's healthy, or she is healthy. And we went to the doctor. I was like right at 6 weeks, 5 or 6 weeks pregnant, like super early. And I know that my friend was visiting from out of town, my friend Shay, which watches my videos. So if you're watching, hey, we went to the doctor. She was visiting the day we went to the doctor, and they did an ultrasound, and I can't remember now. I think we were able to see a heartbeat that day. And I remember them, it was either saw the little baby or we saw the heartbeat. I can't remember now. I think we saw both though. And I remember being so afraid that they were going to say there's nothing, or, you know, whatever. And I had, by this time I had taken like every test known to man. Like, I went and bought like all these pregnancy tests. I couldn't believe it. Like, all the tests are saying positive, you know, like every single one, like you get more excited each one. And I was so nervous, and we saw the baby, and I believe we saw the heartbeat. It was super early to see that, but it was like right at 6 weeks, I think, and we were able to see it, and we could see the baby. See, before we miscarried, we were never able to see that. We just saw the yolk sac or whatever. So I went and saw the doctor that I saw when I miscarried, and she has just become like, she's honestly like was a close personal friend. I loved her. I'm so sad that we moved and I don't get to go see her anymore because she was awesome. And she told me, and she said, I know this is going to be a challenging pregnancy for you because of your miscarriage. I know emotionally it's going to be extremely hard for you. And she said, I want you to come in every 2 weeks. Was it 2 weeks? I think, yeah, every 2 weeks until you can feel him kick. And I will show you the heartbeat. I will let you listen to him. Whatever you need to do to be, not freak out, I will do for you. You come in every 2 weeks until you can start feeling him kick. And she said, if you're having a bad day and it gets too emotional, just come in, even if you're not scheduled, and we'll do a quick ultrasound and I'll show you that he's okay. Or she, I mean, we didn't know it was a boy by then. And so I was like, okay. And so every 2 weeks we went in, and sometimes she would just do like the heart monitor and I would just hear it. And I remember the first time I could hear his heartbeat, just being like amazed that it, you guys know, if you ever have a baby, that heartbeat sound is like the most magical sound. It's like there is a baby inside of me. It's just, it's crazy. And I was so thankful for every good doctor's appointment. And the pregnancy with Nate was so easy. I loved being pregnant. I did have some nausea, but it wasn't anything like, I don't think I ever threw up. Like I would have like queasiness, and I did have to take Zofran like a couple times because it got to where I just felt so nauseous that I couldn't eat. And they went ahead and let me take something. But other than that, and that was super early on, other than that, it was like the easiest pregnancy. I loved being pregnant. I worked at a daycare then, and I worked up until I was about 7 months pregnant or so. And I would just go to work, and you know, we wore scrubs, and so I had this little belly, and it was so fun. Like your first baby, you know, you can wear regular clothes, at least I could, until like pretty far along, because it looked like my body just swallowed a ball. Like I didn't really show a lot all over. And I remember I was like 6 or maybe 7 or 8 months pregnant, and I only gained like 6 pounds. I mean, I'm overweight to begin with, so that could be, I mean, that's probably why. But I just had such a great pregnancy, no complications. I remember the first time I could feel him kick, it was just like the most special thing ever. And then David could feel him kick, and then, you know, he started like moving and flipping and turning. And it's just like, I loved that. I loved feeling him kick. I loved every single part of being pregnant. I know that sounds really annoying, but that's just how it was. And, so as the delivery date got closer and closer, he was due on May 18th, which was 2 days before the year mark of our miscarriage, because we miscarried on May 20th of the last year. So I just thought, it's so perfect. God's timing is so perfect. Well, we lived in Texas and all of our family lived in Alabama. So of course, you know, we were the first grandchild for my husband's family, like for his mom and dad. And then my mom and dad only had one granddaughter. Everybody wanted to be there when he was born. And, you know, so trying to time out like when everybody was going to come, you know, how early should they come? They don't want to miss it. Because if I went into labor, it could, you know, he could have been born before they even could get here. Because it is a, you know, even with planes and stuff, it's a ways. So his family, his mom, dad, brother, and David's grandmother came, and they got there, I believe, like right on my due date, like the 18th, right around then. And then it was baby watch 2012. Everybody was so ready for me to have this baby. And, you know, every day I would wake up and I'd be like, oh, this is the day, you know, like he is coming. And another day would pass and he wasn't here. And we tried everything, y'all. We walked, I jumped, I swam because it was warm. We tried the spicy food, the pineapple. I mean, we tried everything. I would get so frustrating because I would get on Facebook and people would say like, try this, try that. And I'm like, I have tried everything. And we went to the doctor on like Wednesday. She went ahead and said, I was like 1 or 2 centimeters dilated. And she's like, I really feel like it's going to be not too much longer. But she said, I will induce you, because they were worried about his size. And I had like another, my mom went to that appointment with me because by that time they had gotten there too. They came a little bit later. But she's like, we will induce you if you go to the Monday. So I had like till the 28th and they would induce me. So I had like another week or so. So everybody was like trying their best to do everything they could to get this baby out of me. And they did an ultrasound at that Wednesday appointment. And they said that he was, you know, he was definitely getting bigger, but he still had enough room and his water levels and everything looked okay. Okay. So that was on Wednesday. Friday morning, Thursday night, I started having contractions a little bit. They weren't real like every so often or whatever. They weren't like that. They just every now and then I just didn't feel good. Like my stomach was like cramping on and off. I just didn't feel comfortable. We went over to his mom and dad's, like they have this condo and we had dinner with them. And I remember being really uncomfortable, like just blah. So we went to bed and I woke up in the morning at like 4 or 5 in the morning with intense contractions, like intense, like, oh my God, I'm dying. And I feel like I have a pretty strong pain tolerance, but these were super strong. And I remember waking up David and, you know, us timing them. And I don't remember exactly how far along they were, but I remember like, I couldn't talk through them. I couldn't move. Like I was like screaming. It was like what you see in the movies, like super loud. Like I couldn't like, we gotta go to the hospital. Like this has to be it. And so we call the doctor and they're like, well, it wasn't my doctor, it was like the nurse. And she was like, well, you know, you still have plenty of time if you want to come in. I was like, yes, I do. So we lived real close to the hospital. So we went in, we got there probably like 6. I don't remember, somewhere like that. It was daylight. And they hooked me up and she's like, oh, you're not really having contractions. And I'm like, oh yes, I am. I couldn't talk. I couldn't breathe. And she's like, that's weird. Well, she checks me and I'm like 4, I think I was definitely dilated and it was happening. So she's like, oh yeah, you're doing it. And so by the time the doctor got down there, I can't remember the exact details. The doctor came down there and basically they figured out that the little machine, this is so weird because it didn't happen with Lucy, but the machine that showed if I was contracting or not, the little thing they put on your belly, it wasn't showing my contractions at all. Like it looked like I wasn't contracting, but then they realized, oh yeah, you are. I told you. And at first they were like, oh honey, you know, like I'm an idiot. oh, it gets way worse. I wanted to like smack all of them. And I'm like, no, this isn't. And so, okay, my battery's flashing. Hold on. Okay, sorry y'all. So I remember the doctor saying, if you want to go ahead, and I had already told everybody, like, I want the epidural. I've been through enough pain for different health problems that I've had that I'm like, I'm not all about that. I want to have the epidural. I don't want to experience anything that I don't have to. And I'm very glad for the convenience and the awesomeness of epidurals. Even though I was a little bit nervous, I'm trying to fix my light here. I was a little bit nervous of the epidural. But she's like, if you want to go ahead and get the epidural, we're going to go ahead and get you a room. We'll get you the epidural. But I remember just trying to sign paperwork and stuff and just screaming in pain. And that is not like me, but I was hurting so bad. At this time I was like a 5 or so. And, I remember that it was a real busy day and the anesthesiologist, had like several people to do before me. And I remember thinking like it was going to be forever. It felt like forever before he finally came in there. And then they made David leave while they did the epidural. So I was really nervous and I could hear, I always tease him, but it's so sweet. I could hear David praying for me outside the door and he was just praying for me. I was in so much pain. I was so scared. And, when they made him leave, they had my nurse in there with me and she was awesome. I really connected with her, both of the nurses I had for both of my kids. And I just heard him out there in the hallway praying for me. And the epidural took amazingly. As soon as it went in, I felt no pain. I wasn't too numb, like where I couldn't move my legs or anything or feel my legs, but I did not feel pain. And so they said, just try to rest. You know, as soon as you kind of relax and stuff, it goes faster. And so I just rested as much as I could. A lot of, you know, family were just in there hanging out with us. We had some friends from church come, and within not too long, I want to say all between all of that, around like 3:30 or so, they checked me and said, "You're at a 10." And they said, actually, I said, I feel like something's happening. I feel different. And so they checked me and they're like, "You're at a 10. And they said, "We're going to let you just kind of sit here for a minute and just kind of let things happen." I don't really remember if they were waiting for the doctor. I don't remember. And they just said, "We're going to let you labor down." I remember them saying that. And so we just sat in there. I remember us taking some pictures with all the family, like, oh my gosh, I'm thinking I'm about to be a mom. I hope he's okay. At this point, it was actually a week after my due date, so I knew he was a week overdue. And I just wanted David in the room with me. And so everybody left when it was time to start pushing. And first, I'm getting ahead of myself. They go to break my water right around the time they do my epidural. All that happens. And the doctor goes to break my water and she goes, "You don't have any water." Like, it's already broken. And so I'm like, what? I have still no idea. It must have happened when I was in the bathtub or when I was in the pool or when I was in the shower. But with Lucy, and I'll get to that in another video, when my water broke, it was like a continual, like every so often more water would come out. Like for an hour later. With this, it must have just been one. I didn't feel anything. Like, I still don't know how it happened. Thank God he was protected and he was okay. And she was like, "I don't know, but you don't have any water." So that's probably why the contractions were so strong. Because honestly, the contractions were real bad with him. We start pushing, and I pushed. I mean, your first baby, I feel like you're going to push a while. I pushed, I would say, for about an hour. It was actually really fun. I know that sounds so stupid, but I wasn't in any pain. I knew that he was going to be born. So we pushed with the nurse for a while until he got like right there. And I remember David being like afraid. We were so young. I was 25 and David was like 27. And I remember him like not wanting to watch it. And finally he like saw the head and he was like, "Oh wow." And he was watching. He ended up watching a lot of the birth. Not just staying by my head, but I mean, he stood by my head, but he kind of would peek and watch too. And I remember the first time I saw a baby being born, I thought, wow, I was expecting it to be grosser. but it's really cool to watch. Finally, when he was like crowning or whatever, they called the doctor and she came in and a few pushes. I remember saying at the next push, "I'm going to pull him out and then I'm going to put him right on top of you." And I remember pushing him out and the cord was wrapped around his neck, which I didn't see, but David said it. He saw it and they, you know, unwrapped the cord from his neck. And right at the last second, during some of my contractions, I guess his heart rate had been going down a little. And so they put some oxygen on me. Not dangerous enough, I guess, to warrant a lot of the oxygen helped it. So they, that was fine. And then I pushed him out. They put him right here. And I just remember like looking at him and it's like the most surreal feeling of like love. And I just can't explain it. It's like, I can't believe this baby was inside of me. Oh my gosh, this is my baby. It's just like immediate love. We already had his name picked out and we decided on Nathan David. I wanted to call him Nate and David, of course, for David, my husband. And I just love the name. And, I just remember like being just so in love with him. And, you know, after they cleaned me all up, they wrapped him up and gave him back to me. And, you know, I tried breastfeeding. Now breastfeeding with him did not go perfectly. I was very inexperienced. He was a baby that just wanted the milk. He did not want to play around with cuddling and stuff. Like, "I'm hungry, feed me." And that's kind of like how he is now. And so I tried breastfeeding with him. I was not super successful. I did breastfeed him for probably 2 months. But I did have to supplement some because he had jaundice pretty bad. And so we ended up giving him some formula, and that kind of helped flush everything out until my milk came in really, really good. And so because my water broke and we don't know exactly the state of it or what happened, they needed to do some like blood cultures on him to make sure he didn't have any infection. So between that and his jaundice, we had to stay like two nights in the hospital. Two or three nights. I think it might've been three nights. And I was discharged after two nights, and, but the hospital had an extra room open that they let me stay in. I wasn't a patient because they had to discharge me for insurance reasons, but they let me stay and be with him, and take care of him, until he got to go home, which was awesome. I did not want to leave him, but he was just the sweetest baby. I had the best recovery. I mean, within the time I was leaving, I felt great. I mean, I was sore, you know, but, you know, I was back up and moving, and we were, the day we came home from the hospital, I felt great. And, you know, I think the next day we went to HEB and, you know, like I just went back to normal. Of course, it was hard adjusting to the life with a newborn and all of those responsibilities as you're trying to recover. But my parents stayed for a while, for a few days, and kind of helped get us situated. And it was just such a great, easy pregnancy, I guess. Lucy's was a little more scary and complicated. So we'll get into that with Lucy. But my little Nate came into the world. I remember hearing him cry for the first time when they put him on me. And I couldn't believe it after the miscarriage and all the things. He was just perfect. And then the family came in. What a funny story. I hope this isn't getting too long. Funny story. We texted a picture of him as soon as he was born to our family that was out in the waiting room. And we thought it went through. We had like no good service in there though. And so after a little while, right before the family came in, we put a picture on Facebook. Well, they're out in the waiting room and they never got the first picture. So the first picture they saw is on Facebook. And they gave us such crud about that. Why do we have to find out on Facebook? And we're like, we texted you and we didn't get anything. And so like months later, the text finally came through of the picture. And we're like, we told you, we sent it. And so we didn't do that with Lucy. We made sure not to put it on Facebook. But we were just so excited. We were so excited to share him with everybody because he was just so pretty. He was so beautiful. He did have like a lot of red skin, like his skin was kind of speckledy red and he had like a little rash. And so they're not really sure why that was. It cleared up within like a day, but they just said like all the thing, his skin is super sensitive even from the start, and all of the birthing stuff just irritated it or something. So, anyway, that is my little Naders. We call him Naders or Nader Tater. That's my little Nate story. Easy pregnancy, easy delivery. There was one scare. I was about 6 months pregnant. I started bleeding a little and that completely freaked me out, but it just was a little, I ran to the doctor, like went over there as fast as I could and everything was fine. So besides that scare, it was a super easy pregnancy, easy delivery. As soon as all the family came in, we passed him around, everybody got pictures, and we were just all in love with him. And we still are. He's our little man. Okay, guys. So sorry, I changed clothes. My phone rang and I got busy doing stuff, and then I forgot I didn't close out this video. So, clothes change in the middle. That is the story of my little Nader Tater. I hope you guys enjoyed watching. If you're excited for Lucy's video coming up next, make sure you give this video a big thumbs up. Leave me a comment down below. Please subscribe if you are new. We will see you all later.